Hi, I'm Carla.
And I'm Stephanie. And from the International Press Center located at the Atlapa Convention Center, we present to you the last edition of World Youth Day Minute.
The International Press Center opened its doors to attend the thousands of journalists that will cover World Youth Day. It has all the facilities needed, and press conferences are held here to share news during this pilgrimage.
You can download the Panama 2019 app, where you will find important information related to transportation, health, and meals during World Youth Day. Catechesis locations, well-being centers, information points, festival stages, among other topics that will be a big help while you enjoy this beautiful experience.
At the end of the opening mass on Tuesday the 22nd, which will be preceded by the Archbishop of Panama, Monsignor José Domingo Ulloa Mendieta, there will be an event, Panama Welcomes the World. This program will be celebrated with the pilgrims at Santa Maria la Antigua Hill, with the presence of religious leaders as well as Catholic and secular artists.
The countdown has ended. The path taken since Pope Francis announced that Panama will be the location of World Youth Day in 2019 is filled with great emotion and testimonies, and has left a special mark on those who with love and self-sacrifice have prepared this World Youth Day, just like those who have prepared to live it in person or through social media.
If you cannot come to Panama, we invite you to stay connected to the official channels of World Youth Day on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Flickr, and YouTube. There have been 100 testimonies shared through my World Youth Day experience. Let us remain united in prayer for the youth of the world and the fruit of this pilgrimage. Now, wherever you are, it is time to live your experience.
Pilgrims,
volunteers, welcome to Panama!